Burning fossil fuels is a dirty business. Over 30% of the world's greenhouse gases, GHG, come from combusting oil and gas-derived fuels. Making and moving fossil fuels, that is also a dirty business. An additional 10% of greenhouse gas emissions come from oil and gas industry activities, with more than half of that coming from the mid and downstream sectors. Transporting and refining are both energy-intensive tasks. So it's no surprise that the mid and downstream sectors are under growing pressure to reduce their carbon emissions. And this takes two forms. The first is via efforts to reduce emissions tied to industry operations. These are Scope 1 emissions, direct emissions like CO2 emitted from refineries, and Scope 2 emissions, the emissions of purchased electricity. The second way downstream is helping reduce emissions is by shifting toward greener products. In this video, we'll cover the first topic. Then, in the next video, we'll cover the second. Let's start with industry emissions from the oil side of oil and gas. Here, CO2 is the main culprit, and oil refining is a leading source of its emissions. Refineries require massive amounts of energy in two forms: burning fuel to heat the furnaces and using electricity to power the facility. The electricity is easier to impact. Refiners can shift to lower emission sources, like renewables or natural gas, rather than fuel oils. Furnace fuels are tougher to make green. Heating high-intensity furnaces is simply the most feasible with fossil fuels, thanks to their energy density. This is a hard-to-abate use case. A similar problem is facing other heavy industries, like steel production. Alternatives, like using hydrogen fuels or electric furnaces, are possible, but with current technologies, they remain less effective or less economical. A third source of CO2 emissions in the refinery is the chemical reactions themselves. CO2 is often emitted as a byproduct. One way to reduce CO2 emissions, whether from combustion in the furnaces or other reactions, is to capture it on site, but this then requires a long-term storage solution. And indeed, many oil and gas companies are beginning to play a role in carbon capture and storage, CCS, though this is a nascent industry. Beyond the refinery, the other big source of emissions is transportation. Tankers, trains, and trucks delivering crude oil and refined oil products burn a lot of fossil fuels. Alternatives like biofuels, hydrogen or ammonia-based fuels, and EVs are being considered, though this is often led by players in the shipping and transportation industries. Let's turn to natural gas. The same emissions culprits apply. In processing, emissions come from both electricity use and the burning of fuels, though gas processing is less energy intensive than oil refining on both fronts. Transportation matters too. Gas pipelines have powerful compressors. Although some compressors can be electric, most run on fuel, usually natural gas or diesel. LNG ships face the same carbon reduction challenges as oil tankers. Another important source of emissions in natural gas is the natural gas itself. Methane, which leaks across the gas value chain, from processing to transportation. Methane leaks do also happen in oil refineries, but to a lesser extent. On a volume basis, methane is emitted far less than CO2. However, methane is a much more potent greenhouse gas. A molecule of methane in the atmosphere traps heat over 25 times more effectively than a molecule of CO2. To fight methane leaks, companies are increasing the rigor of their leak detection efforts, deploying more IoT-enabled sensors, and even drones that can detect escaping methane via onboard sensors.